Hi friends, now our topic is about biopiracy. So let's talk about what is biopiracy. It came from the root words bio and piracy. Biopiracy literally means the patenting of life. So the genetic materials from plants, animals and other biological resources that have long been identified and developed and being owned by the companies and manufacturers through patents. In short, collection of genetic materials are usually taken without the prior consent. We call it as biopiracy. Biopiracy is the illegal appropriation of life, microorganisms, plants and animals, including the humans, and the traditional cultural knowledge that accompanies it. So it is the illegal because in violation of international conventions and corresponding the domestic laws, it does not recognize, respect or adequate compensate the rightful owners of the life, forms appropriate or the traditional knowledge related to their propagation, use and for commercial benefit. Coming to the history, it's 3500 years ago, Egyptian rulers began bringing the plants home after military expeditions. So in the last century, the British Empire instituted the regular plant collection during the voyage of Beagle. So the Charles Darwin simply took what interested him and brought it home. So the Royal Botanical Gardens took rubber trees from Brazil and planted them in Southeast Asia. They took cinchona seeds from Bolivia in violation of national law and planted them in India. So more recently, during the mid-20th century, Richard Sluts were able to befriend the local shamans who allowed him to collect the thousands of orchard specimens of medicinal plants and hundreds of which have never previously been identified taxonomically. So coming to the types of biopiracy, traditional knowledge biopiracy, genetic resources biopiracy. First, the famous cases are kava, quinoa, banaba and other medicinal plants in Philippines, bitter gourd from Thailand, so lang in Philippines, neem tree from India and rosy from Madagascar. So why is there a need to stop biopiracy? Because of the patenting of biological materials, the locals of the affected countries would have less, if not none at all, access to these new developments, which is possibly their original idea or discovery in the first place. Those who are granted the patents would have exclusive rights to their inventions and can therefore raise the prices if they choose to. By having the license to do whatever they please, the patent owners can also hinder the local production. This can have a large impact on the livelihood of their concerned. The ones who are normally free to use a much of the crops or produce, they need a ban from manufacturing such goods. Therefore, if those goods are the source of income for them, they would lose much of their profits and that they usually get. So the patent owners can prohibit the farmers from breeding such plants and animal varieties as well. In doing so, they have also taken away the privileges that the indigenous people have rightfully earned themselves. As the patent owners benefit from the information and materials that they do not actually own. So the indigenous people who have long been developing and cultivating these resources get nothing. They do not have a choice unless the knowledge of the materials have been proven traditionally and the patent has been cancelled. Actions has taken against the biopiracy. Bioprospecting contracts. To minimize the detrimental effects of biopiracy and to legalize such transactions, there is so-called bioprospection contract. With this contract, the economical income or royalties would be provided to the local communities concerned while the patent owners will generate the earnings. However, the fairness of these contracts has been a subject of debate. Coming to the patent law. In the United States, the patent law is used to protect isolated and purified compounds that were newly discovered and invented. A patent is exclusive rights given to a person so that others will be prohibited in making, using or selling the invention. One common misunderstanding is that pharmaceutical companies patent the plants they collect. While obtaining a patent on the naturally occurring organisms is not possible. So the patent may be taken out on specific chemicals isolated or developing from the plants. Convention on Biological Diversity. In 1993, Convention on Biological Diversity, CBD, established sovereign national rights over biological resources and commits member countries to conserve them, develop them for sustainability and share the benefits resulting from the use. So the sustainable use of biological resources means finding new drugs, crops and industrial products while conserving the resources for future studies. Sovereign rights would be tempered by providing the access to genetic resources in exchange for a share of the benefits, including access to biotechnology. Coming to the conclusion, biopiracy is not stopped, will continue to erode the biological genetic resources of the developing countries as well as denying them fair and equitable benefits derived from their uses. So there is a need to strengthen the policy, institutional and legal frameworks in developing countries, particularly those in southern Africa, which to date have no national legislation on biopiracy. So ABS legal regime should be flexible and tailored made to be particular country needs. So use of capacity building training module on policy and law for biological and genetic resources should be happened. So thank you very much. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel.